Morning is going to be not grace, but first let's go to the word of prayer. Father God, we thank you for today. We thank you for your blessings, Lord, and just be with us as we share your word, and may it penetrate our hearts, Lord, and our mind and our spirit, and just lift us up. And Lord, may we truly understand more about your love, about your grace that you share upon us. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Sufficient grace. That's how the Apostle Paul said it. 2 Corinthians. God's grace. What does it mean to us? I mean, how do we appropriate it? What is it? And basically, you know, God has abundant grace. But he only gives us the sufficient grace. The grace that we need. That moment in time that we are dealing with at the moment. It says in 2 Corinthians, we'll turn there, 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 7 through 10. And lest I should be exalted above measure by abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, a messenger of Satan, to buffet me, lest I be exalted above measure. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord three times, that it might depart from me. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly I rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, in persecutions, in distresses, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Sufficient grace. As I heard many of your prayer requests and testimonies today, this morning, God didn't give us grace for stuff that's going to happen next week or next year or next. He gave us the grace for right now, that moment that we're in. And that's what God's grace is all about. And grace is given to us to meet those needs that we have for that day. He doesn't give us the grace that we need for tomorrow, because that's tomorrow's grace. He gives us grace to meet the demands in our lives at this particular moment so that we can learn to be dependent upon him. This is what Apostle Paul was saying there in verse 9. It says, and he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproaches, in needs, in persecutions, in distresses, for Christ's sake. When I am weak, then I am strong. God's grace is experienced when we reach the end of our ability. Our ability to move and to do the things on our own. It's when we move into our dependence upon him. I think many of us have experienced that in the last couple of weeks. Through the storms. Because there's nothing you can do about a rising river, is it? You just gotta pray.
Right.
Pray.
And it's stopped rising. So.
It's stopped rising. Praise God. So as we go through these things, God gives us the grace. He doesn't eliminate the things, he doesn't take the troubles away from us. Why? Because in those troubles, we get closer to God, don't we? We reach out to him. And significant grace is a product of God's plan for us, a plan for our redemption. It says there in verse 7, at least, unless I should be exalted above measure by abundance of the revelations, a thorn in the flesh was given to me, messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I be exalted above measure. Concerning this thing, I pleaded with the Lord 3 times that it might depart from me. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. The Apostle Paul was a saved man. He knew God. He walked with God. He talked with Jesus. He was there. He knew him. He had prayers answered, many prayers answered. But this one prayer, God didn't take it away. Apostle Paul used it to get closer to God. God used it for Paul to get closer to him. And it's amazing how sometimes we think that, when we become a Christian, that we're home free. Not another word in the world. Things in life happen. Hurricanes come, floods come, loved ones pass. It's tough. But in those moments where we don't know, in those moments where we have no answers, we have God's grace. His grace gets us through. His love carries us on. Isaiah 43:1 says, but now, thus says the Lord, who created you, fear not, for I have redeemed you, and have called you by your name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, there shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Folks, we're going to go through storms. But guess what? He's right there with us. Every step of the way, he's protecting us. He's lifting us up. He's encouraging us. God is there with us. Isaiah 59:19 says, when the enemy comes like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up the standard against him. The enemy wants to destroy us, but God wants to lift us up. God's grace is there for us in that moment, in that time. Romans 8:35 says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for you, your sake, we are healed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Through him, we love them. God loves us. His grace is there for us. His grace goes before us. Sufficient grace. Sufficient grace. It is always there. It is always accessible. God is there with us. There it says in verse 9, it says, and he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. God's refusal to take away Paul's troubles was motivation for Paul to see God more earnestly. That's what God wants to do. Us. He wants to get us closer together, closer with him. Amen. That's what his grace is about. We talk about this hurricane relief. That's part of God's grace. People reaching out. A letter from the district emailed one of the pastors up in New Smyrna Beach. His home was flooded up. And one of the teams from Virginia had come down, and they've been redoing his house that was destroyed or damaged. So they were working on that, but he's still in place. Another brother in Christ donated a condominium for them to estate and for the home is being refurbished for free. So that's God's grace. Now, in the moment, it probably was very upsetting that their house was flooded. And then, looking back, they see God's grace, how He's provided for them, provided a place for them to stay. They found grace that they would not have experienced otherwise. They experienced a closeness with God that they may not have experienced otherwise. So God is there with us. He never leaves us. In Hebrews chapter 4, verses 15 and 16, it says, "For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with their weaknesses, but in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in time of need." Wow. That's beautiful, isn't it? That we have God. He says, come on in. I've got grace for you. No matter what you're going through, I can help you. No matter what you're going through, I can encourage you. No matter what the situation, may not be exactly what we thought it was going to be, but through our tragedies, through circumstances, we get to experience God's grace more than we can ever imagine. Jeremiah 29, verse 12 and 14, it says, "Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. And you will seek me and find me. When you search for me with all your heart, I will be found by you," says the Lord. God's grace. When we are in need, He's there. Where is He? All you have to do is ask. He's there to comfort us. He says, "We will be found." And God's grace is something that we can count on. God's grace is consistent. It's not here today, gone tomorrow. It's there for us, available at all times. It said there in verse 10 of that scripture, it says, "Therefore take pleasure in infirmities and reproaches, in needs and persecution and distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong." Grace is God's gift to us. He never runs out. It's always there. It's consistent. It's strong. Grace is truly an attribute of God. He can't change it. He wouldn't change it. It's like His love. God is love. God's grace to us. And God's grace, you know, it's part of who God is. His grace is there for us. Malachi 3, verse 6 says, "For I am the Lord, I do not change." Same grace that was available to Paul, Matthew, all the apostles, available to us. His grace is there for us. It's given to us. Sufficient grace is everlasting. It doesn't change with the seasons. It doesn't change with our attitude. God's grace is there with us and for us. It says in our weakness, His grace is made perfect. We are made perfect. When Christ touches us with His grace, we're changed. We're lifted up. We're different. Apostle Paul proudly proclaimed his allegiance to Christ. Right before he was about to die, he wrote to Timothy, 2 Timothy 1, verses 11 and 12, it says, I was appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles. For this reason I also suffered these things. Nevertheless, I'm not ashamed, for I know whom I believe, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep what I have committed to him for that day. Apostle Paul knew that God's grace was with him. No matter the circumstances that might be around him, whether he was in prison, whether he was having a good day or a bad day, God's grace was there to get him through those times. So, what do we need? What is it that we need right now? God's grace. What kind of grace do we need in our lives today? You have saving grace. Do you need that? He's got it for you. What about preserving grace? God's protection. Yeah, we need that. God never changes. He's always there for us. What about grace that strengthens us? You know, God's hand is always there reaching for us. You know, I love the little track card where, you know, the footprints of Jesus on the sand, and one, well, there's two sets of footprints, but there's only one set of footprints. The guy says, Lord, where were you when I, there's only one set of prints there. He said, well, God, that's what I was carrying. You see, we may think we're alone, we're not. God's grace is there with us. God is carrying us at times. He strengthens us. What about hopeful grace? You know, during the storm, a lot of us were hoping and praying that we'd get through the storm. There's other storms in our lives, too, that come. Prayed about many of them already. But God's grace will give you hope. God's grace gives us hope that no matter what the circumstances, no matter whatever is on its way, God will give us the grace to see it through. He will lift us up. He will encourage us. He won't leave us. He won't forsake us. He will be there for us, no matter what. So as we move forward in the aftermath, and we need to pray for the people in Puerto Rico, 6 months they say before they may get all their power restored. 6 months. I can't imagine listening by generator around for 6 months. But God's grace will be there for them. He will see them through. And we are blessed as a community of believers. And I know that all of us have gone through certain things, but God's grace is always there for us. God's grace is there, lifting us up, giving us strength, and moving us forward. So as we look ahead to those things that are around us, let's find ways in which we can be part of God's grace, so we can share His love, share His grace, share our blessings with others. Because God's grace given to us for a day, a time, a moment. And the next day, guess what? We have God's grace for a time, a day.
Amen.
Every day, His mercies are new. Every day, His grace is upon us. So let us see how we can share paraphrase with others. Their friends, their neighbors, people in Puerto Rico. Look at the three earthquakes in Mexico. I don't know what the Lord's trying to tell us, but he's definitely getting our attention. We need to look to him for our comfort, not the world. God's grace is sufficient for us, for all of us. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we thank you today for your blessing. We thank you, Lord, that your grace is sufficient for every need that we have, for every new beginning. Your grace is there for us. It never changes. Your love is always there. We thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. Lord, we do lift up those people of Puerto Rico and Mexico and Texas and Florida and all around the Caribbean, Lord, that have had their lives totally uprooted. We pray for them, Lord. We pray that your mercies will be upon them. And that in all of this, we find